Good morning, students. We have started different forms of equation of a plane, correct? So in 6.6 we have seen two forms of equation of plane. One is when normal and a distance is given, and second one is one normal and point will be given, right? So this two we saw equation of plane. Today also we are going to see equation of plane in different forms. Okay, so here first one is equation of a plane passing through three points. So here what will be given? Three points will be given. So using this three points we want to find out parametric vector equation, non-parametric vector equation and Cartesian equation. Okay, so what is this heading? Equation of plane passing through three points. So what is your parametric vector equation? R vector is equal to A vector plus S of B minus A vector plus T of C minus A vector. Okay, so here your A, B, C is a given point. Okay, and T S vector and T vector will remain same. So only what you have to substitute your A vector, B vector and C vector. Now non-parametric vector equation. Non-parametric vector equation is your box product of R minus whatever written here, that you have to take it here. R minus A, B minus A, C minus A box product. Next Cartesian equation. Since this is only 3 points will be given, right? So your Cartesian equation is x minus x1 mod x minus x1 y minus y1 is at minus z1. Similarly, this two rows which is equal to 0 is your Cartesian equation. Okay, so what is this one? 3 points. If 3 points is given, we have to use this parametric, non-parametric and Cartesian equation. And second form, 1 point, two vector will be given. What will be given? 1 point, two vector. Okay, so 1 point, two vector will be given. What is your parametric vector equation? R vector equal to A vector plus SB vector plus TC vector. Now here A is your point, B and C is your vector. Okay, first one is your point, B and C is your vector. Similarly, non-parametric equation, if you take this R to this side, what you will get? R minus A dot B cross C equal to 0. A is your point, B and C is your vector. Next Cartesian equation. So Cartesian equation, modulus of x minus x1, y minus y1 is at minus z1. B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3 equal to 0. This is your Cartesian equation. Is that right? Okay, next. Your third form will be 2 point, one vector. So here how many point will be given? 2 point. How many vector will be given? Only one vector. So 2 point, one vector. And 2 point na AB is your point, one vector na C is your vector. Okay, va? So parametric vector equation is R vector equal to A vector plus S of B minus A vector plus T C vector. AB is your point, C is your vector. Non-parametric vector equation. So when you take A to this side, what you will get? R minus A B dot B minus A cross C vector equal to 0. This is your non-parametric vector equation. Next is your Cartesian equation. So what is your Cartesian equation? X modulus of x minus x1, y minus y1 is at minus z1. X2 minus x1, y2 minus y1 is at 2 minus z1. C1, C2, C3 equal to 0. What are the three forms we saw? 3 points, 1 point, 2 vector, or 2.1 vector. So using these three forms, your xi 6.7, we are going to do the problem that we are going to find out the vector and Cartesian equation of either 3 points or 1.2 vector or 2.1 vector. Take your xi 6.7. First, just we can see all the problems, okay? So what is your first question? Find the non-parametric form of vector equation, non-parametric vector equation and Cartesian equation we want to find out, okay? Wow. Okay, what is given passing through the point? So what is this one? Point. So here one point is given, okay? Wow. Next, and parallel to the straight lines, two straight lines is given, okay? Keep it this in your mind. If parallel or perpendicular word will is given, you have to take that as a vector, okay? So parallel or perpendicular na, the given line you have to take it only the vector. Is that clear? Okay, now tell me first problem, which form we have to use. So here one point is given, and since it's given as parallel, what we have to take? Vector. So here one vector is we can take, here one vector we can take, okay? Wow. So what form we can use? 1.2 vector, correct? Okay, now look at the straight line, this one already I told you, denominator is your vector, numerator is your point. Denominator is your vector, numerator is your point. Have you remembered? Okay, so first problem, which form we have to use? 1.2 vector. Okay, second question, again we want to find out the non-parametric form of vector equation and Cartesian equation. What is given? Plane passing through the points. How many points is given? 2 points is given. So 2 point, and if perpendicular word is given, we have to take only as a vector. So this one you have to take it as a vector, that is 2i 6j plus 6k is your vector, equal to 0, okay? Wow. Now which form we can use here? Second problem, 2.1 vector, correct? Now third one, find the vector and Cartesian equation of the line passing through the points. How many points will be given? 2 points is given, and parallel to the straight line passing through the 2 points, parallel is given. So parallel is given, and what we have to take? Vector we have to take. So we have to change this 2 point into a vector. So which form we can use here? 2.1 vector. Fourth problem, passing through the point. So one point is given, perpendicular to the plane and parallel to the line. So since point is given, we can take it this as 1 point. Perpendicular now, this we can take it as a vector. Parallel now, this is also we can take it as a vector. So 1.2 vector. Clear? Yes. Your fifth problem, find the parametric vector equation and Cartesian equation of the plane containing. Okay, now you have to keep it this in your mind. Plane containing, if you see the word plane containing, then you have to take both point and vector, okay? Ba? So plane containing word, now what do you have to take? Both point and vector. So plane containing the line, this line is given, and using this line, what we can take? First one is a point, second one is a vector. So we can take 1 point and one vector. Okay, wow. And perpendicular. Perpendicular, now what we have to take? Only vector. So this is your vector. Now, what are all the things we know? 1 point and 2 vector. Is that clear? So which form we have to use? 1.2 vector. Next, sixth one. So we have to find out parametric, non-parametric Cartesian equation of the plane passing through 3 points. So here only points is given. So which form we have to use? 3 points. Next, find the non-parametric form of vector and Cartesian equation of the plane. And here one line is given, correct? Since it's given as a plane, what we have to take? Plane container, what we have to take? Both point and vector, correct? So first one is your point, this is your vector, this is your vector. So which form we can use? 1 point, 2 vector. So by seeing the question, you have to find out which form of the vector equation we can use first. So what are the three forms? 1 point, 2 vector, 2 point, 1 vector, and 3 points. Shall we get into the problem? Exercise 6.7, first problem. Okay, so 1 point is given, parallel 2 lines is given. So point we can take it as A vector, correct? So A vector is equal to 2y plus 3j plus 6k vector. Is that right? Now, from these 2 lines, we have to take vector. So denominator is your vector, right? So what is your B vector? 2i plus 3j plus k vector. Is that right? Next, C vector is equal to 2y minus 5j minus 3k vector. So 1 point, 2 vector, we have taken your A, B, C. Now use your formula, that's all. So what we want to find out first one? Non-parametric vector equation, right? So what is your 1 point, 2 vector non-parametric equation? R vector minus A vector dot B cross C equal to 0. This is your formula. So first what we have to find out? B cross C, correct? So your B cross C equal to I vector, J vector, K vector, and B value is 2, 3, 1, C value is 2, -5, 3. And if you take determinant, you will get -4i plus 8j minus 68k. So after find out this, what we have to find? Non-parametric vector equation. So your non-parametric vector equation, we have to use the formula, right? So your formula will be R minus A dot B cross C equal to 0. Is that right? Now R vector minus, this is your A value. Next, B cross C value is this one. Okay, after this, what we have to do is we have to do the multiplication. Dot product only, you know. So we have to multiply this and this and this and this. This one we have to multiply. So if we multiply this two as it is, so R dot minus 4i plus 8j minus 16k vector. Okay, next. We have to multiply this two. So since this is dot product, we have to multiply the coefficients only. So this one we can take it this minus as it is. So minus 8, 8 threes are 24, and this will be minus 16, 6 is minus 96 equal to 0. Again, this one R vector dot minus 4i plus 8j minus 16k vector, and minus 8 plus 24 minus 96 is your 80, minus 80, minus into minus is plus 80 equal to 0. Taking 80 to your other side, so R dot minus 4i plus 8j minus 16k equal to minus 80. So here this is all multiplication of 4, so we can divide by 4. So what is your answer? R vector dot we can divide by minus 4, so this will become I vector minus 2j plus 4k vector equal to 20. This is your non-parametric vector equation. Next, what we have to find out? Your Cartesian equation. So Cartesian equation, either you can use the formula or instead of r vector, what you have to substitute? Xi plus yj plus zk vector dot I minus 2j plus 4k vector, which is equal to 20. Now dot product, I have to find out the answer. X into 1 is x, minus 2 into y is minus 2y, plus 4z equal to 20 is your final answer. Is that correct? So this is your non-parametric vector equation, this is your Cartesian equation. Okay, let's see the second problem. So second problem, what is given? That 2 points is given. So directly we can take your A vector is equal to 2y 2j plus k vector. This is your vector, right? And B is your 9i plus 3j plus 6k vector. And perpendicular, so perpendicular na, that is your vector. So what is your vector is given? 2y plus 6j plus 6k. Instead of x, y, z, you have to put I, j, k. So this is your ABC. Okay, va? So now we have to find out parametric form of vector equation and Cartesian equation. Now this is your 2.1 vector, correct? 2.1 vector. So what is your parametric equation? So parametric equation is r vector is equal to which formula we have taken? So r vector is equal to a vector plus s of b minus a vector plus t c vector. This is your form, correct? So we can substitute the values. R vector is equal to what is your a? 2i 2j plus k, okay, va? Plus s of b minus a, we have to subtract this. So 9 minus 2 is 7i, 3 minus 2 is j, 6 minus 1 is 5k vector, correct? Plus t c vector as it is 2i plus 6j plus 6k vector. Is that clear? So your Cartesian formula, x mod x minus x1, y minus y1, z minus z1, x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1, L, M, N, which is equal to 0, right? Now, what is your x1, y1, z1? That point is given as 2, 2, 1. X2, y2, z2 is given as 9, 3, 6. And L, M, N is your vector. So what is your vector? 2, 6, 6. Substitute here. So if we substitute, what we get? X minus 2, Y minus 2, Z minus 1. And if we subtract X2 minus X1, this will be 7, 1, 5 and 2, 6, 6, which is equal to 0. Now as usual, we have to simplify this one. So if we take x minus 2, now this will be 6 minus 30 minus y minus 2, now 42 minus 10 plus z minus 1, now 42 minus 2, which is equal to 0. Is that right? So again, this will become x minus 2 of minus 24, and this will be minus y minus 2 of 32 plus z minus 1 of 40, which is equal to 0. So again, we have to simplify this. So simplify and you will get the answer. So if we simplify, you will get the final answer as 3x plus 4y minus 5z minus 9 is your equal to 0 is your final answer. Your next problem, take your fifth question. It is given that plane containing the line r vector equal to this and perpendicular to this. So plane containing the line. Now what we have to take? Both point and vector. Perpendicular na only vector. So here we can take your A vector is your point. So A equal to I minus J plus 3k vector. Okay, va? Next, this is your vector. This is your vector. This is your vector. Correct? So B vector is equal to 2i minus J plus 4k vector. And C vector is equal to I plus 2j plus k vector. Okay, is that right? Okay, now what we have to find out? Vector and Cartesian equation. So your vector equation, what is your formula? R vector is equal to A plus SB vector plus TC vector, 1.2 vector formula. So just substitute that value. R vector is equal to I minus J plus 3K vector plus S of B is 2I minus J plus 4K vector plus T of what is your C I plus 2J plus K vector. Okay, va? Next what we have to find out? Your Cartesian equation. So your Cartesian equation, what is the formula? X minus X1, Y minus Y1, Z minus Z1, L1, M1, L1, L2, M2, N2 equal to 0. This is your X1, Y1, Z1. This is your L. This is your M. Okay, so if we substitute, what you will get? X minus 1, Y plus 1, Z minus 3. This will be 2 minus 1, 4, 1, 2, 1, which is equal to 0. Is that right? So as usual, normal multiplication. So if we take this one, and we take x minus 1, this will be minus 1 minus 8 is minus 9. And minus 2 of y plus 1, 2 minus 4, 2 minus 4 is minus 2. Plus z minus 3 of this will be 4 plus 1 is 5, which is equal to 0. So again, if we multiply minus 9x plus 9, this will be plus 4y plus 4 plus 5z minus 15 equal to 0. So minus 9x plus, okay, this one I have taken 2 unnecessary. So this will be 2y 2. So 9x plus 2y plus 5z, and if we simplify this, you will get minus 4, which is equal to 0. Right? So here again, if you do, what is your answer? 9x minus 2y minus 5z plus 4 equal to 0 is your final answer. And your homework is the exercise 6.7, 3, 4, 6, 7th problems. Thank you, students.